In today's episode number one, I will talk about the first thing of why you cannot build any muscle on a vegan diet. And the topic for today is calories. Now, if you want to build any muscle at all, and of course strength, you have to be in a caloric surplus. So you have to consume that many calories that on a week to week, on a month to month basis, you are gaining weight. So when you are stepping on the scales, like every 2 weeks, your body weight should increase. And if it's not increasing, then you are not consuming enough calories. Now, when it comes to the vegan diet and consuming that many calories, in my personal experience, I faced a couple of problems. Problem number one would be it is difficult to consume that many calories. If you are an ectomorph or a hard gainer or in general a very active person that needs a lot of calories to put on muscle. So I have a very fast metabolism, and at the peak when I was weighing around about 90 kilograms, I did need to consume 3,800 calories to put on any muscle on my frame, to be in a caloric surplus. Now in the past, I have made a video on a full day of eating while being on a vegan diet. So basically I will take this meal plan as an example. So basically right now I will go over through each meal that I have eaten at that particular day, and I have eaten this meal plan for a couple of months, maybe half a year on a daily basis. So let's just start meal number one. Maybe I'll put here a picture so you can visualize a little bit better of how it looked, how the volume was like. So when I did wake up in the morning, I used to have 100 grams of nuts mixed with 100 grams of dates and an apple on the side. This was like 1,100 calories, and it was pretty filling. So I needed like 2 to 3 hours before I could get in my next meal. So after these couple hours did pass by, I was moving on to meal number two, and it was a shake. So in this shake I had 150 grams of frozen berries, 10 grams of chia seeds, 100 grams of oats, 50 grams of dates, one frozen banana, and 10 grams of flax seeds. So that was around about 800 calories. And after I have consumed the shake, I needed like 2 hours before I could get in my next meal. Now, meal number three was the nastiest of all. I was basically just forcing myself to eat it because of the protein content that I needed. So I had 170 grams of red legumes, or I don't know how it's called, just look here in the picture. And I mixed them with 200 grams of frozen peas and some salsa sauce, 100 grams on the top. So it was 800 calories. And after I did consume that meal, I needed like 2 hours before I could get in my next meal. And the final meal for the day was pasta with tofu. So I had 200 grams of whole grain pasta. Then I had 300 grams of tofu baked in the oven, 50 grams of soy sauce, and 100 grams of salsa. So that was 1,200 calories. And after I did get in that meal, I was so full that for my next meal, I would need like 4 to 5 hours. So basically, I was already at the maximum capacity when it came down to eating these meals. I couldn't get a single more calorie in my body, or I would just need to force feed myself to the point of throwing up. And now the problem was, I was already at full capacity, so basically if I needed to increase the calories even more to like 4,200, for example, I don't see any option how I should manage it. It's just that difficult to get in calories on a pure vegan diet without eating any crap at all. And don't talk about food selection. You have to choose more calorie dense foods. Just look at the video. I try to pick the most calorie dense foods available, like nuts, bananas, dates, pasta. What else can you eat to get even more calories? These are already very calorie dense foods. And the problem that happened was I did consume that much food that I have started to getting problems. So I was bloated all the time, walking around with a distended gut. The food wasn't digesting properly. Basically, when I finished my first or second meal, I did still feel it in my system, but the time has came to consume the next meal to get my calories in. Because if I would skip that meal, then I couldn't get in the calories needed for the day, so I had to stuff myself. So basically the previous meal was not digested, but I had to put in even more calories. So the stomach got filled even more, so it was even more bloated. And I was walking around gassy all the time, going to the toilet like 8 to 10 times a day. Just diarrhea, and it wasn't getting any better. So don't tell me, oh, you just have to wait a couple of weeks and your body will adapt to it. It didn't happen at all. Maybe it was good for a day or two, but then once again, I got problems with my digestive system. So basically, if you are a hard gainer, it's difficult to get in the necessary calories needed on a pure vegan diet without eating any crap food. Now, another problem that caused me to have these issues with my digestion and bloating, being gassy all the time, diarrhea, is the fiber. Now, I will make a separate video in the future about fiber. But basically, I have here tracked in MyFitnessPal all the food that I have eaten, and in general, the recommendation of eating fiber is 20 to 30 grams for a grown individual. And guess how much I did consume fiber while being on this meal plan? Well, the answer is pretty shocking. It was 71 grams. So that's like double or triple the amount above the recommendation. So I shouldn't be surprised that I have gotten these issues from the vegan diet. Now, if I would need to consume less calories, let's say not 3,800, but cut this in half, so I would need to consume like, let's say, 2,000 calories, then it would be more manageable. I wouldn't need to consume that many calories and the fiber would be not so high. But because I have a very fast metabolism and if I want to put muscle on, I have to eat a lot of calories. Most vegan foods contain some fiber, and I did eat like oats, whole grain pasta, these lentils, legumes, some dates, apples, nuts, so they add up, and at the end of the day, I have this crazy number of fiber. So everything is getting stuck in my stomach, the digestion system is not working, it's blocked, so not good at all. So what is the solution? Basically, I will show you an example of an omnivore meal that I have eaten the last couple of weeks from time to time, and this is only 3,250 calories, so it's not 3,800 because I have lost some weight, so I don't need 3,800 calories anymore. But basically, to illustrate the principle, I was eating the following thing. I had 800 grams of minced beef, so red meat. Then I made some meatballs. So basically, I put the beef in the bowl, and I put in the bowl also 50 grams of white bread drained in a little bit of milk, one whole egg, and some spices, some paprika, and I rolled the meat into a bowl, couple of bowls, so I had like eight meatballs. I put them in the oven on the baking paper, and I did bake them for 10 minutes on each side. After they were finished, I put on top some cheese, 50 grams, and about 100 grams of sauce, so either barbecue sauce or some ketchup. And on the side, I had 800 grams of mashed potatoes mixed with a little bit of milk. And I had like 300 grams of a salad. So it was red beet or whatever it's called in English. So basically, if I will find the picture, I will post it here. And this was 3,250 calories. I had two servings only. And each serving did contain four meatballs, 400 grams of potatoes, and 150 grams of this red meat on the side, and some cheese on top on the meatballs. And I did only need to eat two meals to get that many calories. So after meal number one was finished, I could eat the second meal in like 3 hours. So after 3 hours had passed, I could eat the second meal without any problems at all. And the thing is, I wasn't bloated. I didn't have any gas. And the digestive system was okay. I needed to go to the toilet like once a day, not 10 times. So cannot complain at all. Basically, I don't have any problems with my digestive system at all. I get in the calories very fast, and if I would need to consume even more calories, let's say I would need to consume almost double the amount, not 300, 2,050 calories, but like 6,500, and I could just double the portions and eat it throughout the day, and I will get in that many calories, and I don't see any problem with it. I have an even higher threshold of how many calories I can get in a particular day, and it's not capped to 3,800 calories. I can go above without any problems, and I will not have any problems in my own system. Of course, I don't say that this meal plan is perfect. It's very basic, and it's just to illustrate and purpose of how you can cut down the meal frequency. You can get in the calories even faster, and while incorporating some animal products, in this case red meat, which is very caloric dense, you can get to your target amount of calories, achieving a surplus without any problems at all. So basically, that was my rant on calories. Why is it very difficult to get in adequate amounts of calories on a vegan diet without facing any issues with your digestive system? So that's it for today. I hope you have enjoyed watching this video, and see you soon next time.